Morning. In case you didn't know, tomorrow is the 14th annual American Cancer Society's Making Strides New Orleans 5K walk, but the fun is actually all weekend long. Joining us live in our studio to tell us all about this, we are joined by breast cancer survivor Gina Fortado, and we also have with us this morning Dr. Jane Clayton to tell us about not only the walk, but the fight against breast cancer as well. Ladies, thank you. Thank you for being a part of our program this morning and for coming in and talking about such a worthy cause. First of all, Dr. Clayton, we'll start with you. How pervasive is breast cancer?
This year, about 32,000 women or so will die from breast cancer.
32,000 will die.
In the United States, and about 220,000 new diagnoses will be made in the United States. Of those, about 2,500 or so are made in the state of Louisiana.
Wow, that's worth taking a breath and just, you know, really, really realizing how serious this is. Most people know someone who has been impacted by breast cancer. This is your story. Tell us.
Well, actually, breast cancer does not run in my family, so I'm not the typical person. But 2 weeks before my daughter's wedding in April of 2011, I found the lump myself because I am an advocate for self-breast examinations.
Great.
And about 2 days before her wedding, I found out it was cancer. We waited till after the wedding to give the news to all my family. But I was okay with it because I knew that I caught it early. I knew all of the research, the advancements in the research. I was going to be okay, and I survived through it. I was at the walk last year in a wheelchair at the suggestion of my doctor because I was on chemo at the time. And now I'm here just trying to spread the news.
Yeah, and that's what it's all about, early detection, right? Tell us what women need to do. They need to do their own breast exams. They need to have the mammograms. What age should women start?
The usual screening age begins at 40, as it has for a while. There's been some controversy about when to start in the last few years, but everyone is still staying at 40. Screening every year until there's no end to it, actually. The risk of breast cancer actually increases as you age, and so that's why it's more important for women who, as they get older, to continue to have screening mammograms, even though some women go, "Way, I'm too old for that," but that's not true.
Tell us about Hot Pink Day.
Well, several of the, there are a lot of local businesses in the New Orleans metro area, especially Magazine Street, are help promoting the awareness of breast cancer by sales and so forth and so on. So wear your pink to all of these vendors that are supporting us and to help make more birthdays. That's the main point to get out there.
It's about saving lives.
Yes.
Before we end, please show us this T-shirt and explain to us. I know we're out of time, but what does this T-shirt represent?
This is the Making Strides T-shirt. All of us as team leaders, because I am a team leader, got this. So you'll see a lot of people out there with this shirt on. Then again, we also have other people that will have their own uniforms, like mine is the pink camouflage to combat against breast cancer.
Thank you both, ladies, for being a part of our program. Congratulations.
Thank you.
On winning the battle. Breast cancer survivor Gina Fortado, thank you for being a part of our program.
You're
also
welcome.
Dr. Jane Clayton, thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
Once again, it's the 14th annual American Cancer Society's Making Strides New Orleans 5K walk. It's set for Sunday, and it starts in City Park. Registration is 6:30. And the walk begins at 8 o'clock. For more information, log on to the website on your screen. And once again, that is Sunday, October 7th.